Vice Minister Soon, it is my pleasure to welcome you to Manila and to co-chair with you this 23rd Foreign Ministry Consultations. I note that we have spoken already through our communication mechanism for maritime issues, and I appreciate the brief and candid exchange we had some weeks ago. First, allow me to congratulate the Chinese government for the successful conduct of the two sessions, which saw the re-election of President Xi Jinping and the appointments of new Premier Li Qiang and Foreign Minister Qin Gang as State Councillor. It has been almost 4 years since the last physical foreign ministry consultations, and the Philippines attaches much importance to this mechanism, as our discussions here allow us to cover the overall relations between our two countries and as compared to the bilateral consultation mechanism of the South China Sea, which only covers the maritime issues. If maritime issues do not constitute the whole of our relations, as President Ferdinand Marcos said on more than one occasion, we should be using the foreign ministry consultations more often. We look forward to utilizing these consultations to implement the consensus between our two leaders during the highly successful state visit last January of President Ferdinand Marcos, where we signed 14 cooperation agreements and garnered almost $23 billion in business pledges. Through these consultations, the foreign ministry consultations, we hope to translate the outcomes of the state visit into concrete and high impact engagements that are mutually beneficial for our two peoples, our two countries and peoples. I look forward to working with you, Mr. Vice Minister, to sustain the growth in our cooperation. Thank you. I give you the floor, Mr. Vice Minister.
孙部长，欢迎您来到马尼拉，与我共同主持第23次中非外交磋商。那么，我非常的首先想要提到的是，我们在之前通过外交部的涉海热线机制进行的这一简短但是坦率的交流。我首先想要祝贺中国今年成功举办两会，祝贺习近平主席再次当选国家主席，也祝贺中国选出了新的李强总理和秦刚外长。4年来，我们一直没有机会进行线下的面对面的交谈，今天是第一次。菲方非常重视外交磋商的有关机制，因为它涵盖了中非关系的方方面面。相对而言 ，BCM 机制主要是针对涉海的问题。那么，正如马克思总统在访华期间所说，涉海问题并不代表中非关系的全部。正因为如此，我们更应该用好双边外交磋商的这个机制。 我们此次磋商的重要目的就是要落实两国元首在今年1月份非常成功的这次访问当中达成的重要共识。我们两国当时签署了14项相关的合作协议和文件，那么达成的商业合作的意向的总额接近了230亿美元的这个总的价值。那么我们必须要将这些成果落到实处，这是有益于两国，有益于两国人民的事。所以我也期待
与您共同主持此次的磋商，进一步深化两国之间的合作。谢谢。
It gives me great pleasure, Madam Undersecretary, to co-chair with you the 23rd China-Philippines Foreign Ministry Consultations, and I would like to first of all express our appreciation for the considerable arrangements made for me and my delegation.
我感谢菲律宾政府对习近平总书记再次全票当选中国国家主席和
And I would like to thank the Philippine government for your warm congratulations on the once again unanimous election of General Secretary Xi Jinping as the President of the PRC and also the Chairman of the Central Military Commission, and also for your congratulations for Premier Li Qiang and State Councillor Qin Gang.
那么不久之前，中国的两会顺利闭幕，他规划了今年中国经济社会发展的目标和任务，明确中国要坚持以人民为中心的发展思想，集中力量推动高质量发展，坚定不移深化改革开放，以中国式的现代化全面推进中华民族伟大复兴，以中国的新发展为世界提供新机遇。
Recently, China has successfully concluded this year's two sessions. During the two sessions, we have made plans for the targets and tasks for this year's economic and social development. It is made clear at the two sessions that China will stay committed to the development philosophy that is people-centered, and focus on promoting high-quality development and stay committed to deepening reform and opening up. We will promote the great rejuvenation of the Chinese nation through Chinese modernization and provide new opportunities to the world with our development. And countries in the neighborhood, including the Philippines, will be the first to benefit from such opportunities.
作为两个发展中的邻国, 我们一定要携手来推进各自的现代化进程, 来助力我们各自国家的发展振兴。
As neighboring developing countries, China and the Philippines need to work together for our respective modernization and our respective development and rejuvenation.
这次磋商, 正值马克思总统今年1月份访华不久, 也是 新冠疫情发生，三年多来，我们两国首次举行的外交磋商，双方都对此极高的重视。This
FMC actually happens after the state visit of President Marcos to China in January, and this is actually the first face-to-face foreign ministry consultation we're having after 3 years of the pandemic. So both sides attach great importance to this consultation.
那么我也愿同副外长女士一道，以两国元首的共识为遵循，就中非关系和各领域合作，全面的对表，按照两国领导人为我们指引的方向，深化中非的全面战略合作关系，拓展 重点领域的务实合作，通过友好协商，妥处分歧，推动中非关系继续向前发展，共同维护好中非友好的大方向。We
need to follow the important consensus reached between the two presidents and compare notes on the overall bilateral relations and our cooperation in various fields. Their consensus has pointed the direction we need to make efforts in, and we need to comprehensively deepen our comprehensive strategic cooperation and enhance our cooperation in various practical areas and properly deal with our differences through friendly consultation. And we need to keep to the general direction of friendly relations between our two countries.
那么今天，明天我们还要举行中非的南海问题双边磋商机制的第七次会议，重点就涉海事务深入沟通，所以我们希望今天的磋商也能为明天的会议营造氛围打好基础。
Tomorrow we will have the 7th meeting of the BCM and have in-depth communication on maritime related issues. So we also hope that today's consultation will lay a favorable atmosphere for tomorrow's discussions.
所以面对当前这样一个快速演变的国际形势啊， 中国政府愿意同菲律宾等周边国家一道来加强团结合作，深化我们的各领域沟通协调，来切实维护我们的共同利益和地区的和平稳定。谢谢。
In light of this fast-changing international landscape, China stands ready to work with countries in the neighborhood, including the Philippines, to enhance our solidarity and cooperation, communication and coordination, to jointly uphold our shared interests and peace and stability of the region. Thank you.